another Foodie Friday.
It's your favorite dynamic duo, BMARSZ
and Shanti.
And we're eating something extra special today,
which is Japanese sweet potatoes.
So, I've recently had these for the first time the other day, and I had about a meltdown.
She had a mind-blowing experience.
I immediately texted Chantal, and I said, have you tried these? And she was like, yeah. But if any of you are like me and are afraid of trying new things, I highly recommend these Japanese sweet potatoes.
Yeah. So they look kind of purpley on the outside and they're like yellowy on the inside. That's the only really like defining characteristics of the Japanese sweet potato. Or I think at Trader Joe's they call them Oriental sweet potatoes.
At Whole Foods they said Japanese.
Oh, they did.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so we decided to do just a very simple, easy recipe bang for you guys.
This is going
to
be like a great snack, uh-huh. I feel like. Obviously, anytime you eat a potato, you have to plan to eat a potato because it's gonna take an hour to cook.
Yeah, these took, so we chopped them up into little cubes and we baked them at 400 for like an hour and like 10 minutes.
Some change, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I put salt all over them too.
Yeah, we sprinkled them seed oil. And these don't have any oil on them, guys. And look how like crispy and delicious they got. Like they got so nice and brown.
They did it all by themselves.
All by themselves. And to make this video a little more interesting, we're gonna show you three little dips that you can enjoy with your sweet potatoes. So we're gonna make a vegan honey mustard, sriracha mayo, and spicy peanut dips.
Yum. Okay, what is your favorite dip? Which one do you wanna make first?
Let's do the honey mustard because that one is literally so easy.
Okay.
We did a quick Google search. We can leave the recipes in the description box down below. These are all super like really minimal ingredient recipes. So for the honey mustard, you will need, this one is called literally three ingredient vegan honey mustard.
You'll love it.
So a quarter cup of Dijon mustard. It recommends to use the brand Grey Poupon, which we did not have time to go out and get. So we're using Trader Joe's brand Dijon mustard. This one is very spicy, so I hope that is gonna be,
woo, okay. I can smell the spice.
Yeah, I need to go get a quarter cup.
Okay.
Okay, so I grabbed a quarter cup and I lost it.
Here it is.
Thanks. By the way, all of our measuring cups are literally snap to nap.
Why?
I did that.
Because of me.
Well, like I went to scoop something and it just popped.
I actually broke a plastic fork the other day and scared the living poop out of me. I was like scooping cat poop and I was mashing it like this and I just went poof, and it like literally.
Wait, scooping cat poop?
Cat food. Oh my god. If I was scooping cat poop with a fork.
That's right. I was like,
no.
Did you break the litter handle?
I was scooping the cat food with the fork and I was like mashing it and I pressed too hard and it hit me in the face. The raw cat food.
Ew, that's so gross.
I wanted to die inside.
Okay, so this is a quarter cup. I feel like it's gonna be strong. Going into the bowl. And I'm just gonna scrape this out. And then next it says a quarter cup of maple syrup.
I'm gonna rip this little corner. Maple syrup. Also using Trader Joe's brand.
You
Trader Joe should really pay us.
I know. Do you think they would ever like sponsor a video?
Probably not. They're like such a big company. They don't.
Oh, the lid's on the. There's a piece of paper in there.
What are you gonna say?
You know what else scares me is like whenever like a balloon pops or like I'm very jumpy. Almost.
Well.
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah, like every time you do the pressure release on your Instant Pot, I literally jump. No matter where I am in the house. It scares me.
So there's a quarter cup of maple syrup in there. And I'm just gonna put this aside. And then it said 2 tablespoons of vegan mayo. We're using the brand, Just Mayo by Hampton Creek. I think actually they like have rebranded since we bought this. We bought this a while ago. Like all the jars look different now.
Oh really?
Yeah.
This mayo is bomb.com.
It's so good.
It literally makes a sandwich.
Yeah, I'm a big fan as well. So there's tablespoon one, tablespoon two.
Do you want to mix this while you make the second one?
Yeah.
Get the ball really rolling.
Okay, while Brittany mixes that one together, we're gonna move on to the next dip. These are also good, like, you can use these all for dressings, too.
Mm-hmm. That's a really good idea.
So on this table, we have, like, a little compartment in here, and, like, You will find just anything you need for a mukbang.
I know, we have like crushed red pepper packets.
Yes.
And extra utensils.
Napkins, mirror, chapstick. Just gotta be prepared. All right, for this next one.
Ooh, this looks good.
Oh yeah.
I'll put it right up here.
This next one is 1 cup of mayo, which like honestly is a lot more than I. Should we half
We could
this
half
one?
The recipe, yeah. That's, yeah, a, I don't that's a lot of mayo.
I don't think we could eat a whole cup.
Do you need a half cup?
Yes, please. Also, you know what's kind of cool about this brand of mayo? They like, I've seen this in so many places now. Like, because it's vegan, like you think that you would only be able to find it like Whole Foods or like rare locations, but I've been seeing this brand at like CVS and Target. And yeah,
growing. It actually tastes better than mayo.
I'm a big fan. Normally I wouldn't like just eat mayo straight like this, but
I feel like mayo is like a base of a bunch of dipping sauces that, and I had no idea.
I had no idea that mayo was in honey mustard until I started looking up these recipes. Okay, so this is a half a cup of mayo-ish. I can't really scrape much more out of there.
That's fine.
But what I was gonna say is what you could do instead of mayo is like you could make like a cashew cream base, which is what I do for a lot of dips. It's just like cashews blended up with either water or like almond milk. And then you can add like lemon and garlic to it. And it's like just like a cashew cream sauce.
That's probably like a little healthier.
Yeah, you could
version.
Sub that instead of mayo. But today we're doing the lazy route. Next, it says 3 tablespoons of sriracha. So we're gonna do like 1.5. But we love sriracha, so maybe we'll just do a little extra.
Yeah, maybe we'll do more. Oh yeah.
There's one. You wanna do 2?
Yeah. Boom.
Nice. 2 tablespoons of fresh lemon juice. I cut up some lemons somewhere around here.
They go. Right there, around the peanut butter.
You wanna squeeze one?
Sure.
I don't know if you guys can really see back here. Let's make it up.
We can scoot this back.
Nice.
Boom.
So now we're adding in 2 tablespoons of fresh lemon juice. We're gonna do like a half of a lemon.
Ooh, squeeze. Oh, she's right. Living.
Next, the recipe calls for 1 clove of finely guarded grated garlic. So let's do, I think a clove of garlic is equal to like a teaspoon of garlic. So let's do a half a teaspoon since we have the recipe. Does that make sense?
Ooh, sorry, that's loud for you all back home. Half tablespoon?
Yeah.
Teaspoon?
Teaspoon.
Boom.
And lastly, calls for a pinch of salt. So that's probably good.
Nice. All right.
And then we mix her up. And while Brittany mixes that one, I'm gonna make spicy peanut. Okay, so for the spicy peanut, I kind of like have made up this recipe. I don't really know the exact ratios. I'm gonna try to be as accurate as I can for you guys.
Ah, oh, there she is. Boom. Doesn't that look so pretty?
Oh, that looks great. Okay, now for the peanut, I'm gonna use about like a tablespoon of peanut butter. This is salted, creamy peanut butter.
Ain't no normal peanut butter.
And about a tablespoon of any type of vinegar. You could use like white vinegar, rice vinegar. I'm gonna use apple cider vinegar. We're all out of, I'm gonna use just the sriracha side.
That's fine.
Yeah. Next, we are adding in red pepper flakes to make it spicy. This is from Rev Pizza.
I always grab.
Yeah, I love these little packets, you know.
They're really great when you're packing a lunch.
Mm-hmm. And next I'm adding, can I please have the maple syrup agave blend?
Agave.
And next add just like a tablespoon and a half of maple syrup. And that's really it for this one. Oh wait, usually I add some type of like garlic to this too. Thank you. I'm doing like a little scoop of garlic. And I think that's it. This is gonna be delicious. Oh, I didn't make that much of this peanut, but
sorry. That's okay. We have literally 2 other dipping sauces to choose from.
You know what I love that Brittany doesn't love?
What?
some good old ketchup.
Yeah, I'm just not a fan. It's crazy because growing up, I used to like ketchup. I think I overdid it though.
Really?
Yeah. It's one of those things
I think I've already told you guys this. Ketchup rice is like one of my favorite foods. So we brought over a head of lettuce and I'm gonna do like a little like lettuce cup potato action going on.
Oh, I'm missing my fork. I wanna do that in the second one. I'm gonna try some just in their glory.
Ready?
I'm gonna do some sriracha mayo because there's already a little drop on this.
I'll do honey must.
Honey must.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Mmm. Oh, that's good.
So good.
You know what? We didn't even test these out beforehand. Like, if they were terrible, we just wouldn't even.
No, no. I feel like you can't go wrong, though, with spilled mayo.
So these are like, I don't even know how to describe the flavor of these. They're like sweeter than a normal potato, but like.
But they're not as like overpoweringly sweet
as a sweet potato.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like the like orange ones.
Yeah. I'm gonna grab the sriracha.
Mmm. Oh, this is real good.
Isn't it? Mm. Oh, that spicy mayo. Mmm, the lemon and the garlic is so good in that.
I think the Dijon mustard is really key with that because I was gonna use regular mustard, but I like how it has a little spicy.
Yeah, it is spicy.
It's into it. Do you want to try the peanut?
Yeah. Peanut. Does peanut and potato sound weird together?
Oh, it's good.
Mmm. I think it needs more spice.
Mmm. 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 Ow. I cut my mouth with the sharp potato side.
Nice.
Okay, so. Since it is a food. Sorry, I just used my fork that I'm like eating with.
Oh, I don't care.
Ow, I stabbed myself.
With a potato?
Mm-hmm.
Ouch. Like the crunchy.
Yeah.
And
a pointy end. So since it is a Foodie Friday, we are going to pick a topic from one of you guys. We do this every Friday, so if you want to be featured in next week's video, make sure you leave a comment down below saying what you want us to talk about. Mm-hmm. With your Instagram handle, you have to be following both of us in order to be picked.
This week's topic
comes from Sophie on Instagram or SK Creations on YouTube. Mm-hmm. She says, Foodie Friday idea. This is my Instagram. You guys should talk about alien conspiracy theories and like things you guys think are myths or what you think the government is hiding from society. Mm. Also, maybe like paranormal stuff that might have happened to you or someone close to you. I love you guys. I have a heart transplant and I just love seeing you guys and how BMARSZ supports Shanti's vegan options. Aww. Like when you guys eat a meal together. Friendship goals. Oh my god.
Thank you so much. Wait, she has a heart transplant?
I think.
Or she's getting one.
She's getting one.
Oh my god.
I have a heart transplant.
Wow.
That's insane.
We talked about that in our video. Talk about video.
Oh yeah. Like health problems and all that. Jazz, it's really scary. Power to you. So alien conspiracy theories. Me and Chantal saw this and we decided to watch a documentary we found on Netflix.
Well, I've actually watched it a while ago and then I rewatched it last night with Brittany because I remember thinking it was really good and then I rewatched it last night and now my opinions.
I've changed. So it was called Extraordinary. Yeah, it's called Extraordinary.
Mm, okay.
The Stan Romanek story. So apparently Stan Romanek is a really big name in the alien community. At least that's what I found out after doing some Googling after watching. And I was super excited to watch the documentary because I actually do believe in aliens. And
yeah.
I mean, whatever we want to call them, there's definitely something else in the world.
Yeah. I mean, in the universe.
In the universe. Like, if you think about the universe, we're just, like, literally a speck. It kind of freaks me out to think about the universe. You know what I mean?
So small.
Like, how insignificant your problems are because you're, like, a speck on the Earth in the universe. And there's multiple universes and...
Totally.
Galaxies.
Literally, like, a piece of dust.
Mm-hmm. Mm. And you're only around for, like, maybe 100 years if you're lucky. You're, like... That's nothing compared to how long the Earth has been around.
No kidding, yeah, it's insane to think about, but...
But anyway,
this documentary is just basically this one guy's experience over the course of, I think it's like 15 years with alien interaction. And it starts out, he's like... has all of these UFO sightings. And I'm like, oh, okay, like, you can't really tell if that's like... fake or if that's just like, I don't know. He literally shows so many clips of UFOs.
It's from like the early 2000s. So
the quality is absolutely terrible.
And his video
is filmed on like a flip phone. Yeah. So like that
was kind of hard. But
like,
you know.
Okay, I could see that, but like, can't really tell if it's like believable or not.
Yeah.
Then he starts getting into all these weird interactions. He ends up talking about like his actual like abduction experiences. Like he has all these bruises all over his body
and like scabs that are like perfectly symmetrical with one another.
Yeah, like diamond shaped like scabs. And
which if those are real, that's pretty freaky.
Yeah. And what else happens to him?
Oh, so one of his abductions, kind of one of the only stories I thought were like pretty creepy and might be real, is he said that he got abducted by aliens and they fixed his knee.
Yeah.
Like he tore his ACL and then woke up the next morning without his cast on and his leg was fixed when he was like scheduled to have surgery the next day.
Yeah, he had like scars all over his, or like little dots all over his leg.
He had like five dots in a row on his leg.
And the doctor supposedly was like, oh, like your knee is totally fine. Like we don't have to do surgery anymore.
Yeah. So I was like, that's pretty crazy. But like, I don't know if I'm just being a skeptic because I was like, oh, he could have paid that guy to pretend to be a doctor. Like, we don't know. Because
and like, where's the x-rays?
Yeah.
Where's the proof?
I was reading articles about him last night. And apparently they were like, well, let's like do a scan of your leg. Because he was saying that they fixed it with like something was inside of his leg. And he was like, oh, it's gone.
Yeah.
So I feel like Stan is a liar.
I remember what this needs. Soy sauce. I forgot soy sauce. Hey Colin, can you get her some soy sauce?
There were some other things too, like it looked like he had badly photoshopped like children into some of his pictures and said that he had like 7 or 9 alien kids with this other random woman.
No, it's actually like very like comical. Like he has these images of like a fake alien, like what you dress up for Halloween, like peeking his head through his window and then just like slowly popping, backing away. No, soy sauce.
Apparently
in the cabinet.
Apparently that video, the one of the alien coming up, is really famous. It's called the Boo video.
Really?
And he said like, oh, I had a specialist look at this video. I didn't fake it. To fake a video like that would cost like $1 million.
No, you could have your friend dress up in a costume and then film it with your phone.
Oh.
What do you mean? Thank you.
I think it's
safe. But no, that one is, we should insert a clip. It's actually LOL. Like you thought people were gonna think that's real?
It probably sucks for like people who have had real encounters with aliens because he's kind of like making a joke about it.
No kidding. Well, honestly, what I think is like maybe he did have alien experiences, but he lied about a lot of them. Mm-hmm. Like he shows footage of these flying orbs and I was like, that's crazy. Like that literally looks like it could be, I don't know, like.
Yeah, it's like a red flying orb like multiple times in different scenarios. Or there was one time where
the phone calls of the lady in the British accent.
It was so weird.
Yeah. This other thing that happened, he was receiving weird calls from this woman in like a like very snobby like English accent.
Calling so it's him, almost sounds like computer generated.
Yeah. But like the aliens have like a British accent, English accent.
And I kept calling him Starseed.
Yeah. And we were, I don't know, like
he was kind of making it seem like he was an alien.
No, he was like chosen by the aliens. Mm. They were like, you have experiences that nobody else has and you understand things that no one else does. And I don't know, it was just like, it's like believable for a second, but then what
it would be more believable if he didn't include like the shitty footage of aliens and pictures. Like there's
creeping
another
up through his window. Like
there's one, whatever. Then there's another one where he shows the alien. He said he heard something downstairs at like 3 a.m. So he went downstairs with his camera.
Yeah.
And there's literally an alien that looks like it's made out of clay. Like a gray alien with the big round eyes. And it just goes like this.
And his reaction is like, ah, oh God.
He's like, is that you? What is that? What is that? And the alien just goes like this slowly.
But we both do believe in aliens and like other beings, right?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, absolutely. But
yeah, I don't recommend that documentary.
No.
If you guys have any better alien documentaries,
that was actually terrible, like waste of my time.
Mm-hmm. If you guys have any better alien documentaries you think we should watch, please let us know in the comments below.
Yeah.
It's fun doing these like review kind of videos, but
yeah, that one's not the best.
It also creeps me out because as I was reading like stories about him, I find out that like this last year he turned himself in for owning child pornography. And then the whole like documentary, he's like talking about like this little girl who he thinks is his daughter and how beautiful she is. So it just became like, ugh, so creepy.
Yeah.
And then I find out that he's like trying to blame the government for the children.
Planting the images on his computer.
So it warns like other people who have like had experiences with aliens not to talk. And I'm like, I think you're just a creep.
Towards the end, his story evolves. So now he finds the woman who was abducted with him.
Like, oh, yeah.
He finds her at some like conference or like...
He like sees her in the audience and they immediately like have a connection.
Yeah. He's like, he doesn't know why. And so it turns out he and this woman were abducted together and they have 9 alien children, or like 7 alien children.
Yeah.
And the children were trying to communicate them and they kept on getting these mysterious phone calls from like...
Children.
Far away children voices.
And then his wife... This is like messed up, I shouldn't laugh. His wife is like being interviewed and she's like talking about how like him, Stan, and this like alien wife woman like go off and talk and like how she'd be all jealous and stuff. And I'm like, sounds like a pretty elaborate excuse to cheat on your wife if you ask me. Like, like this is all like,
I don't know. You don't understand, she's my alien wife.
So along with this whole alien conspiracy, we thought we'd talk about some other conspiracies.
Yeah. Overall, we just watched one video. We totally are into aliens, but don't recommend that documentary. It's not good.
Yeah, that guy's a liar. Anyway, do you believe in Area 51?
Oh my god, wait, can I say something really quickly about aliens?
Yeah.
Someone in my town, or actually the next town over, has literally a book about her alien abduction experiences.
Huh?
Yeah, and like claims to be like abducted by aliens.
You read it?
No, but I want to. Or maybe it's not, I don't know if it's like a book or like a essay or like short story or something like that, but yeah, someone in my town claims to have alien, be abducted by aliens. Isn't that nuts?
Do you believe in like, okay, let's just go through a list. Do you believe in Area 51? It's a secret base. Supposedly it's a secret base that the military are either contacting aliens or creating like secret missile military stuff. It's supposed to be in Vegas. Do you believe it's there?
I thought it did exist. They just didn't know what they were hiding there.
Mm-mm.
No, like, it does exist.
It does exist.
Oh, I thought people
just don't know what it is.
Oh, it's just a giant secret? I thought it was a conspiracy that, like, if it existed or not. Oh, debunked. Okay, next one.
Well, we don't know what they're doing there.
Yeah. Do you think they're talking to aliens?
Probably. Is it they're talking to aliens or they're, like, developing
giant missiles? Do they actually have aliens? Or they...
You think they have aliens there?
Some people's conspiracies, and like
they have aliens.
Even like if they have like a UFO there that they're like
deconstructing.
Stuff, yeah.
Wow. So they just like do tests on these aliens? I want to see an alien.
I don't know. If
it's a conspiracy theory. We don't know.
Well, you know what? We need to do some research on this, and we'll get back to you.
Do you believe in ghosts?
I do, but I've never had any paranormal experiences, so I don't really know. Do you?
Yeah, I definitely do, but I haven't really had like big paranormal experiences, but I think I have little ones at the club I work at all the time.
Really? Don't tell me I was scared.
Oh no, they're not scary, but the club I worked at was built in like 1925
really?
Or something. It's super old and was like where like some of the first TV shows were ever filmed and stuff, and some people have died like falling off. You know where they, like, on the top of the stage?
No.
Where they have, like, a ladder and they're, like, pulling up the lights and the curtains and stuff? What is that called? The catwalk.
Really?
Some people have fallen off and died on the catwalk
like
at Avalon.
Like, multiple people?
I think so. And I'm pretty sure they still haunt Avalon because a lot of times when I'm in the stage service station in the back, I can, like, I'll feel somebody behind me and I'm always like, hey, thinking it's, like, one of my coworkers and no one's there. Or I'll, like, hear footsteps. But the place is big and maybe it's just, like...
That's terrifying.
Someone I don't see, but... No one's ever messed with me.
They're nice ghosts?
I think so. The place is terrifying. Like, if anybody wants to do conspiracy videos, you should stay the night at Avalon. Like, I feel like Shane Dawson should do it. It's terrifying.
That's so scary.
Mm-hmm. But
yeah.
Do you think that demons are real?
I don't know if real.
No, I don't think demons are real. I think they're...
No, I mean, I was gonna say, I don't know real in the sense, like, how they're portrayed, but I think, yeah, they're definitely real. I think there's, like, bad spirits.
That's what I was gonna say. Like, I don't think there's demons in the sense of, like,
exorcism. Oh, like horns.
Mm-hmm. Like, the little horns are like, but maybe, like, a spirit who is, like, angry, it's dead, or just wants to mess with people.
Yeah.
Do you believe in getting, like, someone to be possessed?
I don't know. I really don't know about that one.
I don't know either. Do you believe in psychics?
I feel like I want to, but I don't know.
I do. But it's hard because there are so many phonies out there.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like there are some people who, like, can meditate and, like, contact the spirit world and are, like, a medium. But I don't really believe in the people who are like, let me read your palm and flip over your cards, ooh, and, like, look into the crystal ball.
You think there's some people with, like, a sixth sense?
Yeah. I believe in, like, mediums and, like, people who are more connected to, like, the non-physical world. But I don't believe...
Like, read your palm?
Like, read your palm, tarot card type.
Well, I...
Stuff as much.
Not read your palm, but, like, read your future.
Yeah. I feel like there's, like, people who can talk to their spirit guide and...
Yeah, I totally believe that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm trying to study that shit. I'm reading that book, The Law of Attraction, right now. It's like, I don't know. It all talks about how the whole book is written because one person is a medium and is, like, talking to her spirit guide. I would love to talk to my spirit guide.
It's actually funny. I talk about this in a vlog that I'm going to upload tomorrow.
Mm.
And we met a guy in Malibu in the Starbucks. You're sitting next to him. And he was from our town, went to the same high school as Kathy, is like 40 or 50 something years old, and was a medium and spiritual guide.
Did he say anything to you guys? Like, predict anything? Or like?
No, but like, how random is that to be in Malibu across the country and someone is literally from your hometown that went to the same high school as your friends? Like,
how did you start talking to him?
We were charging our phones next to him, and then he was like, we were talking about the Super Bowl, and he like brought out like his Patriots hat, and we were like, oh, like, we're from the East Coast too, like, where are you from? And he was like, literally the same town you're from, like, said the town. And we were like, oh my god, that's so weird. But yeah, he was a medium. And he said that one day he was walking and he said something about, like, Jesus came to him and opened up his third eye so he could, like, see everything. And he was like, I have to practice it, but, like, I can see it. Like, he said that, like, voices talk to him and stuff. And I don't know, I guess I could believe in that, but... Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. It was cool, though. It was interesting.
It makes me want to, like, meditate. I feel like meditating is the key to everything, but meditating is so hard to me.
You think meditating will give you your spirit guides?
Maybe not. I don't know if I have the ability to connect with the non-physical world just because my own real world is so hectic. I feel like you have to have a lot of inner peace.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm always like...
You feel like you either have it or you don't.
Yeah. But I do feel like meditating will help, like...
Calm me
down and, like, make me see life more clearly.
Oh, it's just totally.
I always feel like I don't have time to meditate, which is literally the point of meditating.
Yeah, gotta schedule time for it. I told him, I was like, oh, like, I want to learn how to meditate. Can you teach me how to do it? He's like, well, I'll schedule a session with you. And I was like, can you just tell me now?
Yeah, you can just tell me.
We're here right now.
That's funny. I'm not driving back to Malibu for this.
Yeah. Oh, but anyways, I'm so full. This was delicious and, like, so much fiber and, like, fills the belly up, you know? Yeah.
It's a great, healthy snack, you guys.
Or meal, like, I'm stuffed.
I know. I really recommend wrapping it. That was the adjective I wanted to use. And lettuce, it is really nice. I love, it's like hot and squishy and cold and crisp.
Uh-huh. So good.
You'll love to see it, guys.
Well, anyways, let us know your favorite alien conspiracies and if you believe in ghosts and all this paranormal talk that we're doing. I think we're definitely believers to, like, a certain extent, like,
mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I've never had any personal experiences, so I can't really talk from experience.
Let us know if you have. Also, make sure you leave any topics you want us to talk about in the comments below. I already told you what the criteria was, and if you're new to this channel, welcome! We are Mukbang Monday. We post videos on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and they are recipes, mukbangs, and a fun chit-chat for you to join in on.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And yeah, I think that's basically it.
Foodie Friday out.